In this lecture, we're going to learn how we can customize the style of the navigation menu. Before we jump into this video, go to training.mammothinteractive.com. Here you can sign up for the Mammoth Unlimited membership and get access to all of the courses we've ever created. That's over 2,000 hours of content. Inside of our code editor, if we go into our header, we can see where we created the navigation menu. We created the menu with a nav HTML tag, which means that we can style this tag because it is the group or container for the navigation menu. So join me in style.css, which is where we're writing our styles. And let's style the navigation menu. All right, so here we are going to change list-style to none. So that way we won't have any list type here on our list. Okay, now if we want to be able to actually change the list type, we have to specifically go into the list object because we are just accessing the nav object currently, which is just the container for this list. You can see this is a list because it has here bullet points. Now, inside of HTML, an unordered list, meaning a list of bullet points, not numbers, is represented with a UL HTML item. So actually, behind the scenes of this navigation menu, which was created for us by WordPress, we actually have an unordered list like this with opening and closing HTML tags. And inside of there, we have a list item with opening and closing tags. There's a list item for each menu item, like for example, one list item for the home page. Then there's another list item for the next page, which we had as our sample page. So this is what WordPress has created for us behind the scenes. So if we want to style the list, we actually have to go into these tags, the UL unordered list tag, and then the LI list item tag. All right, I'm going to just delete these because they're not required, but we can preview what they look like. Here you can see I just created them and there they are, they're a list. Now let's delete them because we don't need them. WordPress created that list for us because we called WordPress nav menu. All right, so we can go back and we have our regular page. Just give this a moment to update. All right, and so when we want to style the list, we have to actually go into the unordered list and then the list item. All right, I'm going to save this file and refresh. And look at this. Now we don't have bullet points anymore. And I still have these two just because my server is updating. It takes longer to update a PHP file than a CSS file. Okay, so now I've removed my bullet points. How did I remove the bullet points? Well, because inside of my style.css file, I set my nav ul li list style to none. So this series is not actually referring to all three. This is referring to a navigation HTML item, inside of that an unordered list HTML item, and inside of that a list item HTML element. So this is actually nesting. So we're saying that we're looking for the list item inside of an unordered list inside of a nav. All right, so it's not actually changing all three, it's just changing the list item, the last one, and then all the ones before it are referring to the parents. So instead of styling every single list item, we're only styling list items that are inside of an unordered list, which is inside of a nav tag. If there's a regular list item that's not inside of an unordered list, maybe it's inside of an ordered list, and maybe it's inside of an unordered list, but it's not inside of a nav element, well, in that case, it won't be styled. So that is how you can style a child of specific parents. All right, so, and we can refresh our page. Okay, now our two pieces that we created earlier have been deleted, and we just have here our list, but now we just removed the list style from it. So we removed the bullet point. Okay, next, around each item, I'm going to add an outline. So we're currently inside of each item because we are inside of the LI element. Here I'm going to add an outline property. I'm going to set this to 1 EM as the thickness. The type of outline will be solid. And then the color, I'm going to use our variable dash dash gray. That's the variable we created to represent a gray color. I'll save this, and in my browser, I'll refresh. And look at this, we have all of our elements here being grayed out. So what I want to do on these is float my elements. Okay, so I'm going to go back into my code here, and I'm going to add float left onto my elements and refresh my page. Okay, now that looks a lot better. So I did float left, which means that now each of the elements will be floated. So instead of taking up all of its space, it will just take up however space it needs, and then it will stick to the left side. So there's all of our elements right now. Let's add some space between each of our elements. So I'm going to, here on each list item, I will add a margin, and let me just space these out a little bit. So on each list item, I'll put a margin on all four sides of 1 EM. Also, this outline is quite big, so let me actually change this outline to 0.1 first, just so you can see. Okay, let's just set the outline to 0.1 EM and refresh. Okay, so this is what it looks like when our outline is 0.1 EM. All right, so each of our elements is still in a list without bullet points, and each of them by default takes up 100% of the width that they have of their parent. So that's why they have 100% of their body, of the body of the page. And remember, there's some margin around the body, which is why they stop at a certain point. So by default, each list item takes up 100% of the space possible, but that we can change. So remember, we added float left. So when we add float left and we refresh, suddenly they don't take up 100% of the available space. Now they actually only take up however much space they need, and then they get floated left, so they get floated beside each other. So they're now beside each other instead of all inside of a list. So that was thanks to adding float left. All right, and on top of this, I'm going to add some margin. Let's do 1 EM. All right, and then let's go and refresh the page. Okay, so now we've spaced out our elements so they're easier to read. Let's make the outline thicker because right now it's a little too thin. It's hard to see. Let's change this to 0.5 EM, then refresh. Okay, that's a lot thicker now. We could do even smaller, really. Now, as well, I am going to change up another property here, and that is going to be the padding. So with outline, we know that we can do outline offset as one option, but another option is actually to do padding, which means we can actually set the space inside of an element that the element takes up. So a margin would be the space around an element that an element takes up, but padding is the space inside of an element that an element takes up. So let's put some padding as an alternative. We could just do here our text decoration or outline offset. We could do outline offset, but let's do padding instead to learn something new. So I'm going to set padding to 1 EM and refresh. And look at this. Now, all of my navigation items, they have padding inside of them. Okay, so the outline is not right on the text because now the object itself has padding inside of it, and the outline always goes on top of the padding. If we put margin, the outline would not go on top of the margin, but it would go on top of the padding. Okay, so we notice that there is some conflict right now between our elements. They are a little bit low. So let's just change this up a little bit. So we can put some less space around each of the objects because currently we're not able to fit all four of our elements. So here we can change up the margin. We can reduce that to 0.5 EM. Refresh. Okay, now great. All of our elements are able to fit on one line. Now, if you zoom in, then they do stop being able to fit on one line. So if you are developing for mobile, you have to keep in mind that if you zoom in, you may have to change your code a little bit. That is on responsivity, making your website work on different pages, and you can actually split your CSS to be a certain way for mobile and a certain way for larger screens. Okay, as well, we need to add in some margin on the bottom of our navigation menu and also perhaps the top if we wanted to, because currently here it's conflicting with our first post. So we can go into our editor, and currently we have some margin on all four sides. We could also add margin bottom, so just on the bottom only of 0.5 em and refresh. Okay, let's see if that is going to be a bit better. Okay, it is a little bit better, but I think we need a little bit more. We could also, instead of changing the margin bottom here, we could just change the margin bottom on the entire header, because inside of our header.php file, we can see that the navigation bar is actually inside of the header. So we could just increase our margin bottom on the header. So let's change that and then refresh, and look at that. Now there is a lot more space. Okay, so we could also change the margin on the top as well if we wanted to have some more space on top there. Now for this navigation menu, I also want to remove the underlines because that is conflicting. We don't want too much styling. So if we want to remove text decoration, then we can do that on each list item. We can just set the text decoration to be none. So here for the list item, I'm going to add another property, text-decoration, and set it to none. Now, if you try to refresh your page, you'll notice nothing will change. The reason being that we already set text decoration one time. Remember, we set it here in our anchor tag. We set text decoration to underline. So we actually have a bit of a conflict here between the anchor tag and the list item. And an anchor tag is always going to win when there's a conflict between an anchor tag and a list item. So if we want to actually make sure the text decoration is applied, we have to change what we are styling here from the list item to the anchor tag instead. Then we can go into our browser and refresh. Okay, now we see we have a bit of a difference here. Okay, so what we have is all of our elements have changed a little bit. And maybe you want this funky menu, but likely you don't. So what we're going to do is put it back to what we had before. Just save this and refresh. And then I'm going to just move only the text decoration to a different styling, to nav ULLIA. Because that way, this anchor tag will win against the conflict. Because remember, we had a conflict between the list tag and the anchor tag for text decoration. And the anchor tag is going to always win. So instead, I'm going to style the anchor tag specifically inside of a list item in an unordered list in a nav tag. Then I can go into my browser, refresh, and look, now the text underline has been removed because now this styling won in the conflict. There still is a conflict between this anchor tag and the previous anchor tag styling. This style is going to win the conflict because it is more specific. It is an anchor tag inside of a list tag, inside of an unordered list, inside of a nav tag. It's more specific than just the general anchor tag, so that's why it is going to win. All right, so if we didn't have here the specificity and then we refreshed, well then all of our links would be removed because yes, there would be a conflict, but this time the anchor tag styling that is further down the file will win. But if you move this and put it above the other one, then it will now lose and the early anchor tag will win. It's going to be this anchor tag that will win, the one we created earlier. So now if we refresh, all of our links will be back. So if there's a conflict and the tags are exactly the same, the one that is further down will win. But we don't want to remove text decoration on all of our anchor tags, only on the ones inside of a nav, which has an unordered list, which has the list item, which has the anchor tag. So now the child is an anchor tag inside of a list item, inside of an unordered list, inside of a nav tag. So we only want that text decoration to be none. And this will win the conflict because it's more specific than just a general anchor tag. So there are rules for how conflicts are handled in CSS. We can refresh, and there we go. Now we have our nav menu acting as expected. One more thing we want to change about here, our anchor tags, is let's change what happens when we have hovered and clicked on one of our elements in the nav bar. So here I'm going to add another property for a nav, unordered list, list item, anchor tag, and that is going to be on hover. So here, this is actually a cool thing in CSS. You can change how an element appears when someone's mouse or cursor hovers over the element. We're going to set the background color property to our variable dash dash gray. So we'll change the background color of the anchor tag upon hover. We can refresh our page and look at this. Now, when we hover over this, the background color of the text changes. Now, what if we wanted the background color of the whole object here? Well, in that case, we here can go into our list item, colon hover, then we can refresh, and this time, every time we hover over the whole list item, the color changes, okay? So there we go. That is going to allow us to change the color when we hover over the actual list item. Now, you may want to make the whole list item clickable then, because here we can see when I hover over this, I still can't click unless I hover specifically over the text, and that can be confusing. Your visitors might be clicking and wondering why they can't go to that page. So to be able to allow the whole list item to be clickable, what we're going to do is back in our code, we're going to just move our padding, which is what creates that space inside of the element. We're going to move that from the list item instead to the anchor tag. Right, so now the padding will be on the anchor tag. Then I'm going to save this file, fix the formatting first. Okay, we can just leave it at that, or hit undo and it will restart. All right, then I'll save this and refresh. Okay, and now we'll notice something different we get here. Our hover is now going to be just taking up the word in the list item and also the left and right location or space. So if we want the background color to be on the whole item, what we're going to add inside of our code is here on the list item itself for the anchor tag. We are going to add another property, and that will be the display property. This sets how the element is displayed. And by default, for a list item, the display is list-item. And for an anchor tag, it is inline. So we're going to change it to block, which means the anchor tag will behave like a paragraph, and it will take up its whole width. If I refresh my page, I can now see we have the hover effect. So I can hover over each of these boxes and the background color will change, but on top of that I can now also click anywhere in the box, whereas before I had to click exactly on the text, which can be really annoying for users. So this is much better for user experience. Awesome, and that is the hover effect. Now, what if we want to also specify what page the user is on? Otherwise they could be on a page and not even know where they are. You could do this by adding a page title at the top of every page, and that would be useful. Another option in the navigation menu specifically is to actually set the color of the active item. So you can set a background color for whichever item is currently active. For that, we are going to use a built-in WordPress class. So I'm going to go into my navigation tag, my unordered list, and my list item, and then use the class current-menu-item. So this here is a WordPress class, and it allows us to get the currently selected menu item. Then the list item. We're using the list item because that is what we used to change the background color of each of those menu boxes. So current menu item comes from WordPress. It's a WordPress class. A class is a way to specify that you want to style a certain element with this certain list of properties and their values. And you can put a class onto any HTML element, such as a list item. We could create our own classes inside of our HTML just by using the class property on any navigation menu and setting this to the here current-menu-item. So this is how you can set the class of an element. Then from then on you could use dot class name to reference the class and create its styling. WordPress actually already has the current menu item class for us applied to whichever menu item we are currently on, whether that's the home page, the sample page, or a different page. So then we can just change the background-color to our gray. So it's going to change the background color whenever you hover over an item, but that's only temporary, whereas this color is permanent for whatever item is currently selected. One note is we don't actually have to set the li here. We shouldn't, that will cause an error. You want to leave this at just li.currentMenuItem, because it's just like we did with hover. We specified the parent tags, then the tag itself that we are changing, li, then we specified only on hover with a colon hover. Here it's similar, we're specifying the two parents, then the actual element child that we want to style, and then we grab .currentMenuItem, which means that we're only going to be styling the list item that has the class currentMenuItem, and we specify it's a class with this dot here. All the other list items will be left as they were. Only the list item with this exact class will be styled. So adding li here, you actually shouldn't do that because that is redundant and will break the code. You should just leave it as this. All right, let's save our file and then we can refresh our page. And look at this. Now, whatever menu item is currently selected, that is now colored with this background color. And that is a lot better for user experience. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to go to training.mammothinteractive.com. Here you can sign up for the Mammoth Unlimited membership, where you can get access to over 350 courses that we've created.